With all this theoretic background now and our little exploration, we are ready to get for a more formal definition of algorithm analysis. So in computer science, the analysis of algorithms is the determination of the computational complexity of algorithms. And what is this computational complexity? Well, it's either the amount of time, storage, or whatever resources necessary to execute them. So usually this involves determining our function that we talked about here. Our function f from n from our analysis that relates the length of an algorithm input to the number of steps it takes. So that is then the time complexity. Alternatively, we are interested in the number of storage locations an algorithm uses, which is the space complexity. So how can we proceed to analyze the complexity? So in fact, we already did such a little analysis for our search example. And generally the idea, simplified for you, is that we have a look at our loops and their possible iteration values. We have to consider function invocations, of course, because within a loop we may call another function that has internally another loop. And we have to consider recursive algorithms that call different functions, and there is a crosstalk between the functions. This often requires a thorough investigation. It's often good to come up with a first worst case bound and then tighten this bound in subsequent more detailed analysis. When you do such kind of analysis, you will find out that, interestingly, in computer science, often what we do in algorithms is that we trade space versus computation. So in our case, in our search algorithms, we any which way needed a space of n to store access our values that we want to search. However, you could imagine more clever ways of storing data that we will look at. And in this case, we need much more space, but we will be able to search much faster. So we can conclude that space and compute requirements depend on the actual data structures that we use and, of course, of the algorithm. And now let's have a thought. Can you imagine an O of one search algorithm? How could you do that if you had infinite storage available? Think about it for a moment, and we will come back in a minute. Right, so it's not no shame if you couldn't figure it out. It's really a tricky task. Okay? Right, so if you have thought about it, think about again what complexity this algorithm really could have, right? You know, does it really have O of one? Are you sure about it? How do you know about it? Right, think about this general approach. Is there a loop inside that goes up to n? Then probably it hasn't as a complexity of O of one. So now, here is our answer. We have in fact the lookup tables. What are lookup tables? Well, they store all possible values of the search domain. So we have if our key has d bits, we have to store 2 to d elements. So what we do, we create an array cell for each possible element. And if the key does not exist, we have to store null. Otherwise, we fill the value. So we have basically here an element that doesn't exist, and we have some values, then up to 2 to the power of d elements. Let's give an example. You want to count the number of each character in a text. Yeah, you can create a simple table that contains a slot for each character of the ASCII set. The ASCII set has 128 independent characters. So we have to remember this array, and now we can directly access a specific key k by looking in this table into the required location at position k. So it works for small problem domains, but if you have larger domains, the lookup tables become so enormous large that it's infeasible to use them.